Hey guys, Collar here, bringing you Set 3, the 2v2 matchup in the Pro League series, Air Force Ace versus Samson Khan, and I am psyched about this game. I really like to watch 2v2s and to play them, and even though they're harder to commentate, I really like to commentate on them also. And especially because this game is not a mirror matchup, it's actually Zerg and Protoss for Air Force Ace versus Zerg and Terran for Samson Khan. And the series so far is tied 1-1, but unfortunately for Air Force Ace, this game they will be facing the second-best 2v2 team in the Pro League last year, which is Samson Khan's Jihyun and Cute Boy. And they managed to achieve a 14-4 record last year. Jihyun, a Zerg player, and Cute Boy, a Terran player. Usually that is the matchup. The lineup we do see for 2v2 is Zerg and Terran versus Zerg and Terran. But this time, for Air Force Ace, we have Rage playing Protoss and Klon playing Zerg. So we're definitely having a divergence here, and this in some ways may lead to a longer game. Air Force Ace will have to pull something up their sleeve, though, to be able to defeat the Zerg and Terran force here that is the Samson Khan 2v2 team, especially because they just specialize in this. They're not 1v1 players at all. In any case, let's take a look at the starting positions here. We have in teal, which they're going to click first, Klon playing Zerg for Air Force Ace, and his partner is blue at 3 o'clock. The Protoss player Rage for Air Force Ace. For Samson Khan, we have the purple Zerg Jihyun at 12, and I believe we have the red Terran Cute Boy at 6 o'clock. And Hannibal is a new 4-player map for Pro League. This is the map they're playing on Hannibal. Each of the main bases is on a ramp leading towards the natural expansion. There's 4 more natural expansions around the map, and a central fighting area in the middle that's on low ground. It's a pretty standard looking map, actually, so I'll be expecting... It reminds me a lot of something like, not really Python, but it's like Luna, perhaps. It would be a good comparison, actually. Something like Luna. In any case, looks like Supply Depot going to be built in the base for Cute Boy. It looks like a 9 pool here for Klon. And let's see what his partner's doing. His partner is getting his gateway in his base. Yeah, I won't be expecting any kind of fast expand from any player on this map. The expansions are fairly difficult to hold, and of course, this is a 2v2 game, so early game units are much more valuable. But it looks like the purple Zerg, Jihyun, for Samson Khan is going for at least a 12 pool, if not even a 12 hatchery. And we'll see if Klon can take advantage of that. If Klon can't, then he will be behind the other Zerg. And looks like he is going for his gas really early, so possibly going for Speedlings. And we see a 12 pool for Jihyun here, and 2 gates for Rage for Samson Khan. So cross positions, 12 and 6 for Samson Khan, 3 and 9 for Air Force Ace. And we could see the Terran going for, I'm guessing he's going to be going for mechanized units, because the assumption here of the Protoss player is that he's going to go for Templar, because he can get Archons to deal with Mulus quite effectively, and also get Storm to deal with Terran units, and Medic Marine would be very, very susceptible against a Storm. And looks like a second hatchery going up for Jihyun there, and only one hatchery going to Lair for Klon. So Klon actually going straight for Lair, going for a one hatchery Mutilus build, and he really needs to make this count, though. I think that Jihyun should have a scout in Klon's base, and now Klon moving towards Jihyun's base. He has a scout in his base too, but a sunken colony cleverly being placed at the front door, and I don't think that Klon's Zerglings... Actually, if Klon manages to get some Zerglings behind the sunken colony just to rush past them, he might have some success and take down a few critical drones here. Looks like Klon about to ascend the ramp, though. It looks like 4 Zerglings out for Jihyun. That's going to be more than enough to deal with this. And Azella coming up for Rage, but it's probably not going to be enough to break this ramp. This ramp will be quite difficult to break with the Sunken Colony on top of it. And looks like Rage actually building a pylon inside of his ally's base here, perhaps to set up some cannons, because he does have a forge in his base. Looks like the red player... Cute Boy is going to be able to scout out this early lair and know that one hatchery Mulisks are coming. And looks like an attack going on now at Jihyun's base, but this attack's going to fail, I think, because the Sun Colonies are just going to take care of the Zealots. No, actually, one Zealot still survives, and he's starting to pound on this Sunken Colony here. We'll see if these Zerglings can prevent the other Zerglings from surrounding the Zealot. Now 2 Zerglings from from Klon desperately trying to take down a drone or two, but looks like they won't be able to take down any drones. Actually, they did manage to take down two Zerglings. Surprisingly, I guess they were already low on health. So two Zerglings for Klon still alive in Jujun space, but he really needed to go and attack and kill off a drone to make this count, though. Looks like two cannons being placed in front of Klon's base in order to protect him, because the opponents do know that he has gone for a one-hatchery build, which will leave him very susceptible if his mutilists don't work out as well as they need to. Looks like, actually... Q-Boy's actually, I think he's got two barracks actually going in his base, and now he's getting his factory. He's going for an academy, actually. So, Q-Boy's actually going for a medic marine build here, and I should have guessed that from the fact that he has five marines now. He's definitely going for a medic marine build, and this might be very susceptible to whatever Rage can pull off here. If Rage can go for high Templars and attack these medic marines and storm them, the Samson Khan team might face a serious deficit here. I assume that Rage will be going for High Templars if he has a scout on this at all, because going for Reavers would be quite more difficult with the Mutilus flying around the Scourge. So really, you would need those Archons and the High Templar. That is the best option to take. And of course, going for Stargate is just not going to be effective against the Terran. You might be able to take down Mutilus. Ooh, looks like a miss micro by Klon there. I don't know what happened. He probably just clicked all the drones and moved them by accident, but costing himself a little bit of mining time. Meanwhile, Marines are going to execute his Overlord inside of Jihun's base, unfortunately for him. And he's going to be behind an Overlord, which is not good given the state of his economy. Looks like a creep colony and an evolution chamber going up for Jihun. So Jihun's going to be going for some spore colonies. The first mutilus out for Klon now. Only two mutilus, though, possibly because of the food hit there. He does have to morph a new overlord, perhaps. And looks like now four mutilus total. And three mutilus here are going to be going towards Jihun's base. But Jihun has a spore colony by now, I think, within his mineral lines. And he won't be able to do much with these mutilusks. He should just probably focus on actually harassing the Terran if he can. It looks like the Terran's actually going straight for science facility off of one base, so he's going for a sort of a one base Samson Khan, SK Telecom, rather, build here. Just a one base medic marine and science vessel build. And it looks like Aspire now finally going up for Jihun. Jihun playing more of a defensive game, actually, getting a lot of defensive of structures. And actually, that's going to cost him a little bit, because he's built four defensive structures. That's a lot of drones and a lot of minerals being used for defense. And looks like Klon didn't have to sacrifice anything for defense, because his ally, Rage, has just been building cannons everywhere. But for now, really, Klon would not be able to attack Jihun at all. Klon making note of this fact with his Mutilisk, seeing this spore colonies, knowing he's not going to do much. And I feel that Rage should not be building this many photon cannons. I feel it's a little excessive. He needs to build some offensive units to be able to deal with this. Although right now, perhaps he's just thinking of getting a slow start. But the critical factor will be Cute Boy now. Cute Boy this time. Cute Angel was last game.